Hey guys, well, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and it is making this on the 3-dimensional logo designing where there is a basic shape of alphabet D. It has got certain thickness, and on top surface we can see there are different rings of colors. So to design this logo, we'll first use the Ellipse tool and create out the shape and tweak few of the vertices. Then we'll use the 3D option to create this depth, and then finally we'll add these different rings of colors with the help of pen tool and shape builder tool. So let's begin the tutorial. Let's select the Ellipse tool and create an outer circle. Once you have done that, we'll use the direct selection tool and drag this vertex down. So with the shift and arrow key, I'm dragging it down like that. After that, with the help of anchor point tool, we'll break this point. And now we'll bring out the ruler, control R, and we'll bring out the ruler scale and place it around here. And what we'll do is we'll drag this handle still here. So I'll select this handle, and with the shift press I'm dragging it down till much. And the same way from here also, I'll drag this down handle this much so that I can maintain this flow. I'll delete this ruler and control R to remove that scale. Then once you have done that, next thing is we'll just rotate this to an angle. You can see it's still slightly tilted, so I'll rotate this almost this much. You can see that. Okay, fine. Once you have done that, let's fill it up with certain color, like a different color like blue, and I will remove the stroke color. So next thing is, we'll duplicate this, control C, control F, and I'll place it in the middle, and I'll change the color to white with R, because I select the color from here, white, and let's place it in proper place, like around here. Okay, just push it up a little bit like that. Okay. And we can scale this down a little bit more like that. So once you have done that, we can just delete this out from there. So I'll select everything, go to Pathfinder and subtract it, and now it's done. Now next thing is we need to create this part. You can see this extended part, so we need to draw it with a pen tool. So I'll use the pen tool. I'll just select the pen tool from here and draw the shape. So I need one from here, just give a little angle and just connect it from here like this, giving it the flow. I'll break this point from here and zooming in and click on that, and it will automatically break there. And next I'll make this one, so I'll just click around here and just complete the shape like that. Later on we'll do the tweaking, like we need that part, so we'll just go in and maintain the flow with the direct selection tool. Just select these points, and you can edit the handles. We'll just change the color to something else, like this one, and let's work out with the handles. Now I'll just select the handles and make sure it's maintaining its flow. Over here I'll select this point and place it in a proper way, select this, move this, place it there, and select the handles, make sure it maintains the flow, zoom it in, just select it and place it there, like that. In the same way we can see that, okay, we need something here. We'll just select this little bit and push it here and just maintain the flow like that. Let's check it out. Okay, so once you've done that, I'll select both and go to Pathfinder and combine it. Now it's one object. You can see that we can scale this up a little bit like that. We can just extend this a little bit more with the die selection. I'll just select this and move it a little bit at that side, and I'll play with the handle, select this, select the handle, and maintain the flow like that. This one I'll just select this and make sure it's good. Okay, so once you have done that, next thing is select the object, go to effect, 3D extrude bevel, and here we'll create the 3D depth here. So I'll just make sure everything is zero, select this, 0 0, and now preview it. Now we'll slightly tilt the angle, so I'll select the middle one, and with the scroll mouse scroll I'm rotating the angle. So I'm rotating around -23, and on the top one I'll just give a little bit of tilt, like around maybe 9 or -10, and give some perspective. Let's give some perspective view, like around let's give it around this much. Okay, you can see that. So now you can play with the depth here, and you can even increase the extrude depth, like this much, how much you want to give. We can give, adjust the rotation like this, and okay. So once you have get that, click the OK button, and we got the shape. Now next thing is we'll have to edit this. So now select the object and convert this into object form. Go to object, expand, appearance. Now ungroup it twice or thrice. So ungroup it. Now every pieces are separate. Now next thing is we'll select this both and make it one. Select this and let's first release clipping mask. In the same way, select this, release clipping mask, select these pieces and move it a little bit aside and select the clipping mask and delete it out and place it again back to its position. So we'll zoom it in and place it back to the position, select it and place it there. In the same way, select the top one, move it aside, select the clipping mask and place it back to the position, zoom it in and place it back. Okay, and make sure they are placed properly like this. Okay, now next thing is select this, make it one. In the same way, this is okay. Now we'll do little thing adjustment. We'll do these adjustment here. You can see we have got these at this point it is 1 point, and on the top it is also 1 point, so we need to correct that. So we'll tweak little bit here, select this. We'll first remove all these vertices. So with the delete anchor point tool, I'll select each of this and delete these out, like going in here, just clicking on that vertices and it will be automatically removed. And if you click on another area, that message will appear. So we'll delete out all these unnecessary points. We don't need this, don't need this, we don't need this. Just delete it out like that, this, and we are left with that. Now next thing is just look at it. Okay, here we don't need this also. So on the downside also, we remove everything like this. Okay, select this, delete it out, and we are left with one. Now let's do the adjustment. I'll select this and we'll play with the handles. So let's extend this handle till here and this one little bit on top. Just push this down a little bit like that so that we can maintain the flow like that. This one will reduce the handle like that. Now let's do little adjustment here. We'll select these points, these from two objects, dragging and selecting it, like I'm dragging and selecting, and just move it a little bit inside like here. Now we'll do the adjustment for properly. So we'll just select this and make sure they maintain the flow like that. You can see, we can see that there is some thing, so we need to just make sure it's, until it's not good, you have to just tweak and tweak and tweak so that you can get that perfect curve like that. Now next thing is we'll do here also with the delete anchor point tool. We'll remove these points, we'll remove this, keep this and remove this also, and after that we just select this and drag it up here until here and just play with the angles. So I'll select the anchor point tool and make sure it maintains the curve like that, and with the die selection tool I'll tweak it here, give me the proper flow. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, just push it in a little bit, select it, put it inside and do the adjustments like that. And okay, now you can see we have got that. Now here we got this. Now next thing is we need to create this subdivisions. So to create that, we'll use the pen tool, draw a few stuff here. So we can see that it starts from here. So select this from here and draw a nice curve here, going through here, around here, maintaining the flow and touching this point. And let's click, give it a little bit curve here also like that. I'll just finish this at this point. We'll remove the fill color like that. Now we need to draw one more here, so I'll just continue this and draw the curve around here and make sure it's going through here, like maintaining the curve and finishing it at here. So just finish it properly with that finishing touch. Now I need to draw one more here, this division, so I'll draw it new. So from this point, I'll just draw out one around here like this and going to this point like this and giving it a curve, nice curve. Now let's do a little bit adjustment with the direct selection tool. I'll just go in here and select these points and make sure it touches that point, and we'll play with the handle so that it maintains the flow. The same way, select this, we'll just try to maintain the flow. Select it, push it up a little bit, curve, select this. Okay, this is good. This one we need to do a little adjustment here. Just select this and we'll just push this outside a little bit, this in the middle, and this one, let's check where is the point. Okay, here it is. We'll just push it a little bit down like that, and here we can see we got that curves. Just maintain the curves, select it, maintain it like that. So once you have done everything like that, we'll select these pieces, like select clicking and dragging these pieces only, the surface and the three curves which we have drawn. And now with the shape builder tool, I select the shape builder tool and let's select a color. I select one color from here and just click here and give that color to that. Okay, before that, let's check out where it's missing. Okay, we can see that this point is inside that. We have to just push it out, like selecting it, and let's drag it out a little bit outside like that. Okay, now we can do that in the same way. Let's check it out for here. If it's done, okay, that's good. So let's select it again. We'll just drag and select it, and with the shape builder tool, just fill it up with color. So I select the blue color and click here. You can see that. Next, I'll select the yellow color and fill it here. Next, I'll select the pink color. Okay, that's good. And I'll select the green color and click here. Need to give different color here. And okay, all this is good. Let's fill it up with the color. So I select this with the eye picker and shift and alt press, I select this color. In the same way, with the V selection tool, eye picker, shift and I. V, I, shift and alt pressed. With shift and alt press, you can select the color. Now, V for selecting the object, eye picker, shift and alt pressed, just select the color. V for selection, I for eye picker, shift and alt for color. And for this also, with this V, select this object, with the eye picker, select this color. Let's do the adjustment. Now select this and let's check it out. I'll go here, transparency, and let me check opacity, good, gradient, let's check it out, it's linear. Okay, now with the gradient tool, let's do the adjustment like this. We need dark around here, lighter in the middle, and at the end again dark. V for selecting the objects, G for gradient, adjust the gradient color, it's linear, that's good. We need that dark in the corners, light in the middle like that, giving it a nice highlight. In the same way, select this, G, and drag. Click and drag in the angle you want it. Select this, G, click and drag. So we need lighter here, darker there. So in the same way, we have given that. Let's check it out. Okay, like that. Now next thing, we need to give the other piece. Select this, G, and in the same way, click and drag, giving it a different contrast. Same way, select this one, G, click and drag, and you give that contrast. Now you can see we can delete this extra lines, delete it out, select it, delete it out. And now we left this, just select this with the eye picker, shift and I, select the color, G for gradient, adjust the colors, giving it a gradient, nice look. So we have given that, we have given everything. Now let's give that highlight, and we'll do that by selecting all these pieces and this also. Let's duplicate this, Control C, Control F, go to Pathfinder and combine it. Okay, you can see that. Now let's fill it with some different plain color like blue. Okay, that's fine. Now with the pen tool, we'll draw out the shape. You can see that wavy shape. We'll draw it out from here, giving it a curve. One around here, giving it a nice flow, and finishing it at here. So let's change the stroke color, select this, white, and you can see that we have given that stroke curve like that. If you feel that's too, it's going to be done a little adjustment, you can just go in there with the direct selection tool, just do the adjustment like that, make it the flow perfect like that. So once you have done that, we'll select with the selection tool, select this, this, and with the shape builder tool, just make this one object. Let's fill it up with certain color, like let's choose yellow and fill it up with that. Let's make this one like that. So once you have done that, we can just select this edges, select it, delete, delete this piece, and fill this up with this color which I have chosen. If you look at it, I'll just go to gradient. You can see I have given two color in the gradient, white and white, where one of the portion is given 95%, that's 100% opacity, and the other one is given 0. And after that, we have just applied that gradient color here, like in a way we wanted. And if you go here, we have given the total, the overall opacity around 40, and that's all. So we have given that glossy effect on top. Last thing is we have to add the text. So with the text, let's type it out. D-U-A-L dual, and the font which we are using is Niala, and let's find it out here, N-Y-A-L-A, Niala, it's here. I just select this and here we go, and let's do a little tweaking. If I go to character, let's keep the distance around, let's check it out, 1500. Okay, let's scale this up a little bit around 20. Okay, that's huge. Let's play with the font size. Okay, this is cool. That's cool. And now place it there in your position. Let's increase the gap around. That's 2000. Check it out. Okay, that's also cool. So finally, we have added the text and we have finished up with our logo design. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. And also for business inquiry, you can check out the email on the screen, and also you'll find it on the description below. Thank you.